Hey, it's Joe, and I'm back talking about Selenium IDE and all of my excitement about the new Selenium IDE. I forgot to mention two of the biggest features in Selenium IDE that's going to change your automation efforts in a big way. I'm not overstating it, I don't think. When you see these two changes, I think your mind's going to be blown. So stay with me and check them out. The first one is the locator element selector functionality that's been added to the new Selenium IDE. When you record with Selenium IDE, not only does it record what it thinks is the main identifier for your element, it also automatically records all the other ways it can use to identify that element. And the reason why that's huge is a lot of times you may have a developer that changes the name or the ID, but doesn't go back into the actual automation code and change it. So when you test runs, it fails, right? So it's just a maintenance nightmare to have to go in and make that change. Even if you're using page objects, you still need to go in, make it. What's really cool about the new Selenium IDE is that if it doesn't find the preferred locator, it will go through all the other locators automatically to find that element. So that's going to save you a lot of time with maintenance and make your tests a lot more reliable. So that's a huge, huge feature that's going to be a game changer. So the second change is really what I used to call, I even wrote a whole article on this, the number one killer of Selenium script performance and reliability, and that is synchronization. So a lot of times people will create a test and not add any type of synchronization to say, before I interact with this element, is it available? Is it visible, right? They just automatically made assumptions and just went on to try to perform a step on that element. And so a lot of times the test would take a long time to run or would just fail randomly because that element sometimes appeared within a certain time and sometimes it didn't. And then they'd have to go in and find out, okay, what's the best synchronization method I can use so I can make my test more reliable. So they have these explicit weights and implicit weights and all these different ways that you can actually use to synchronize your test to make sure before it interacted with an element that it was available to be interacted with, right? So that was the number one killer performance. People were totally forgetting to add that to their scripts. With Selenium IDE, the new version, you don't have to worry about that any longer. Automatically adds those weights for you without you having to do anything. So you record your script, and when you play it back, it automatically knows what to wait for and adds those synchronizations in for you automatically behind the scenes. So two killer features, and honestly, the two biggest ones that tend to cause your tests to be unreliable and hard to maintain have been addressed in this new Selenium IDE. Check it out. Tell me what you think. Let me know how it works for you. And like I said, I believe Apply Tools really is putting a lot of effort behind this new Selenium IDE, and they'll be improving on it. It's not that old already, so over time, I can only see it getting better and better. So any request, as Dave said, even if you don't write code to an open source project, adding a ticket with any bugs or defects you may encounter is contributing to open source. So make sure you're active no matter how much or how little you feel you can contribute. All right, that's it for the new Selenium IDE. If you haven't already, subscribe to my channel. As always, test everything and keep the good. See you next time. Cheers.